Hey everyone, welcome to part two of the video series where we examine the life cycle of writing and deploying a Chialisp smart coin. This tutorial assumes you have already gotten your environment set up and you're ready to start writing some Chialisp. If you did not watch the first video, you should probably go back and give that a watch before you start here, just to make sure that you have everything set up that you need before we move forward. Now that all that's out of the way, let's go ahead and start writing some Chialisp. First, we need to decide what kind of coin we're going to build and what its requirements are. In this tutorial, I've decided that we're going to demo a piggy bank coin. That is a coin that stores value and cannot be spent until it reaches a certain savings goal. We made a few design choices that we think will highlight some of the very cool features in Chialisp. The first choice we had to make was what to do when we reach the spending goal. For simplicity's sake, I decided that when the piggy bank reaches its defined goal, we are going to have it automatically cash out to a predetermined address. We're going to set the address that the money goes to when we create the piggy bank coin, rather than trying to do any shenanigans and pass to the piggy bank coin where we want the money to go once we've reached the savings goal. I also decided that I'm going to allow anybody to contribute to our piggy bank if they like, regardless of whether or not they have a valid signature. This is a very cool example of how coins can enforce their own rules without really caring about who is spending them. Lastly, we're going to have the piggy bank recreate itself after it has cashed out to automatically start a new spending goal. This is a very cool example of how Chialisp coins can go on in perpetuity. They will live on forever, whether or not even you try to stop them. Okay, cool. So we have our requirements out of the way. Let's go ahead and start writing. I've made a project directory here. I called it Piggy Bank Project. It has a virtual environment in it, and I'm just going to go ahead and make a new folder. I'm going to call it Piggy Bank. This might seem silly having a piggy bank folder inside of the piggy bank project, but this project will get much more bloated later. So this is a good first step to have. And I'm going to go ahead and add a file in here called piggybank.clsp or Chialisp. All right, we're going to go ahead and start this Chialisp program just like every Chialisp program starts with a mod. And we're gonna go ahead and define our arguments here. I like to have them on different lines. All right. So the first argument that we need is we're gonna need my amount. This is the current amount of the coin that is being spent, and we need it so that we can validate that money is only going into the coin and not coming out of it. So for example, our second argument is going to be new amount, and we're gonna need to make sure that this new amount is greater than my amount. That way no one can try to cheat this system by passing in a new amount that is less than the current coin amount. The last argument that we're going to need is my puzzle hash. And the reason that we need this is because whenever a coin gets spent, it gets destroyed. So we need the current puzzle hash in order to recreate ourselves with the new amount. We're not going to want to change the puzzle hash at all. It is always going to be this puzzle, but we do need it in order to create ourselves again. This is all of the solution values that the spender is going to be passing in, but we also need a couple of values that we define for ourselves to make this our own. Other people may try to use this smart contract, but if we don't have some unique constants in here, all of the puzzle hashes are going to be the same and everyone's going to be able to spend everyone else's piggy bank. We don't want that. So we're going to define two constants here that are going to make this coin unique to ourselves. Let's go ahead and type def constant. And the first constant that we're going to define is target amount. The target amount is our savings goal. The piggy bank will not allow any subtraction of value until it has reached at least this value. For this example, I'm just going to go ahead and set our target amount to 500 mojos. I realize it's not a very lofty savings goal, but it will at least be very good for testing. I'm also going to create another constant that is the cash out puzzle hash. This is going to be the address that the money gets sent to as soon as we reach our savings goal. Presumably, we put our own puzzle hash in here, but that may not necessarily be true. Maybe we're using this as a fundraiser for charity. We put the charity's puzzle hash in here, whatever. When the savings goal gets reached, this is where the money is going to go. And in this case, I'm just going to use a filler because it doesn't really matter of 0x cafe food. Cool. This is all of the variables that we're going to need. So let's go ahead and get into the main control flow of our puzzle. It's pretty straightforward. First of all, whenever we create the main entry point of our application, we like to just leave a little comment here letting people know that it's the main entry point. It just makes everything a lot easier to read. Usually this is at the bottom of the contract. All right, so what do we need to do? We need to check two things. First, we need to check that the new amount is greater than my amount, and we also need to check whether or not we've reached the target amount. And that's it. That's the only checks that we need to do in order to spend this coin. So let's go ahead and handle the first one first. If new amount greater than my amount, and then we've got our two possibilities here. If it is true, we're going to continue, we're going to do stuff. And if it's not, we're going to raise. Parentheses X just means raise. So if anyone tries to pass in a new amount that is less than our current amount, we're just going to automatically fail. The coin will not be able to be spent. Everything will stay exactly the way that it is. But if they pass in a new amount that is greater than the current amount, we're going to go ahead and do our second check. If new amount is greater than the target amount, then we're going to do our cash out logic. And if the new amount is not reached the savings goal yet, we're just going to go ahead and recreate self. And that's it. That's the main control flow for our logic. I'm going to actually define these functions in the next video. But for right now, this is the basic skeleton of our Chialisp project. This is the main logic for how our variables will be evaluated when we try to spend this. In the next video, I'm going to go over what conditions we need to use to make sure that this puzzle is usable on the blockchain and can assert a certain information to make sure it's secure. Until then, I will see you guys in the next video.